If you have a concordance, I have. I need it, you see, I need it to make things easy for me. In the concordance, the word Emmanuel occurs only once in the New Testament. Only once. Matthew chapter 1 verse 23. Only once. So if he was supposed to be called Emmanuel, somebody must have called him Emmanuel. In the 27 books of the New Testament, the word Emmanuel does not recur, does not occur again. Once only. That means nobody called him Emmanuel. So if a prophecy is made that this thing is going to happen, people will call him Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Emmanuel. Then we'll know, says he was called by people Emmanuel. If there was a prophecy about John Washtela, Caron Washtela, that he will become the Pope in 1981 of the Roman Catholic Church. There's a prophecy. There was a prophecy. I'm asking the Pope. His name is Caron Washtela. That's his native name. When he was born, he was baptized Caron. And Washtela is his surname. It's when he becomes a Pope, then the name changes. He takes on a title. Pope John Paul II. The one who died before him in 1 month and 3 days. The previous Pope. 1 month and the people poisoned him. He took his place. That was Pope John Paul I. So he took the same title as Pope John Paul II. That's his choice. I said, if you had never become a Pope, and there was a prophecy about Caron Washtela becoming a Pope, and you didn't become a Pope, what does it mean? It's worthless, rubbish. Even if there are 1,000 prophecies about Caron Washtela, he'll become a Pope, and if you didn't become a Pope, nobody called you Pope in your life, then you're not the Pope. Somebody must call you Pope. Pope John Paul II. Pope John Paul. We call him so. So now I said, if there was a prophecy, the prophecy is fulfilled in you. This was supposed to be fulfilled in Jesus. Did his mother call him Emmanuel? The schools, children with whom he was schooling, did any one of those children call him Emmanuel? Did any of his disciples call him Emmanuel? In his life, while he walked this earth, is there a single person called him Emmanuel? He says, no. Then I said, what kind of prophecy is this? Huh? You're just thumb-sucking something, like a little baby, spoiled child, it's your toy. You say, this is it. But nobody called him Emmanuel. Emmanuel. I don't know whether you had the chance of reading Edwards. Emmanuel. There was a film here, man, pornographic film. It was banned in this country under the old government, under the new government. Emmanuel, pornography. This woman is a harlot, a whore. A prostitute, Emmanuel. This was a film going on here for quite some time in Durban. Do you know that? And thank God you people don't read all that. Emmanuel means God with us. But the name of the prostitute, would you call her Miss God with us? Miss God with us? That's what it means. Huh? That prostitute, if you met her in the flesh, will you call her, what's your name? Say, my father gave me the name Emmanuel. Possible. Would you call her, says, God with us? Miss, this prostitute, you're going to bargain. You say, God with us, God with us. What's the price? Huh? Is that how you talk? Is that what? Emmanuel means God with us. No, that's what it means. I said, there are so many names. There are so many names. You see, the Jews gave their children names. We give our children names. Beautiful names. Our Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His father had died before he was born. His grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, he takes him to the Kaaba as an infant in his arms. And he's introducing this little child, his grandson, to the chiefs of the Quraysh. They're asking, what's his name? He says, Muhammad. He said, Muhammad is a very strange name. First time we hear that word. He said, you see, I want my grandchild to be praised throughout the world. That's his ambition. He's a mushrik. The grandfather is a mushrik. But this is his desire, that my grandchild, the remnant of my son, Abdullah, I want his name to be broadcast throughout the world and praised throughout the world. And it happens. his wishes fulfilled. 5 times a day, every day of the year, the muazzin goes on top of the minaret and he shouts, Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Every name has some kind of a sentimental connection, some prophetic quality. So he, grandfather of the Prophet, gave this name to our Nabi, Muhammad, the praised one. May Allah have him praised. Then we find in the Bible names like Eli. In the book of Samuel, first book of Samuel, in the Bible. 32 times there is a priest, his name is Eli. You know what Eli means in Hebrew? My God. Eli means my God. My God. That's his name. His name is my God. Mr. My God. How are you, Mr. My God? Hey, his father is calling him my God. His mother is calling him my God. Everybody is calling him my God. Eli means my God. So, and Jesus on the cross, according to the Bible, is supposed to have cried with a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Which means, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Was he shouting for the priest? My God, who? That priest? My God? No, this is the name. People give name to your children that maybe they imbibe that quality of ever thinking that God is with you. Eli, my God, everything, my God, my God. We have a family here called Bismillah family. Yeah? You know, the wives of Dr. Mayat and Dr. Mal. Dr. Mal's wife passed away, I think in an accident. In an accident, yes. Zohra Mayat of the Cultural Center? Yes. You know what's her surname? Anybody know? No hundred round for you. Anybody know? Bismillah. No, her surname is Bismillah. See? Bismillah means in the name of Allah. That's a surname. This is his brother, her brother, Bismillah. Mr. Ahmad, Bismillah. Our brother Muhammad, Bismillah. Our sister Fatima, Bismillah. No, means that is a surname. In the name of Allah. In the name of Allah. In the name. That's a name. She's not Allah. The father is not Allah. No, this is a name, a quality that you are giving. You want the person to be ever remembering Bismillah in the name of Allah. Everything you do, Bismillah. In the Bible, you have a prophet by the name of Joel. Joel. Joe means Jah, they say. It means Yehovah. Jehovah. El means God. He's God. Yehovah God. That's his name. Joel. And General Dayan, you know General Dayan of Israel? The one-eyed man? His daughter came here to South Africa. She was a journalist. And you know what's her name? Ya'el Dayan. Ya'el Dayan. That's her name. You know what Ya'el means? Oh God. Oh God. Ya'el means oh God. This is the name people give their children with the idea that they have this godly quality. Ever thinking, oh, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Wallah, Wallah, Wallah. But Ya'el is not, oh God. She is not God. Her father didn't think when he gave the name, he says, this is my God. Or the mother says, this is my God. No. These are the names that you give to people that may they imbibe those qualities. Emmanuel. You must have that quality to be called Emmanuel.